Hi everyone, this is Dave from Geekanoise, and what I've got here is the Cambridge Audio G2 Mini Portable Bluetooth Speaker. Now, Cambridge Audio makes some fantastic audio equipment, and this is really no exception. It's beautifully made, available in a range of colours. They're very kind to send me the gold colour, which I was happy about because I've of course got the gold iPhone 6. Now, the colours don't match anywhere near really, but I do like the sort of rose gold finish on the G2. I think it looks very classy indeed. Now, inside the box, as well as the speaker, you do get a power adapter. You also get a 3.5mm to 3.5mm audio cable and this nice little soft pouch for carrying this around in. Now, this is a portable speaker. It's got a battery built into it, up to 10 hours of battery life for music playback. And you can also use that internal battery once it's charged up to actually charge other devices. And I'll show you how you do that in a short while. So the design cues on this are very nice design, very sort of soft, white accented speaker grille on the front, the Cambridge Audio logo down the bottom here. And then across the top, we've of course got this metal gold casing, really nicely finished. And all of the controls are sort of indented into this panel. And this has got a rubberized finish to it. I like this a lot. Very, very nice indeed. We've got the ability to take calls. So we've got a speakerphone function. We've got Bluetooth pairing. We can select the auxiliary input. We've got NFC as well. Volume up and down, and then the main power on off button. If we look at the sides, they've just got a nice smooth rounded finish to them. And we've got this slightly angled foot on the bottom, which just sort of raises the front of the speaker up. It's nice and subtle, but it works really well. And then round the back, we have got the same design with this speaker grill. And then we've got a little plastic piece here which covers up some ports. And if I just open this up, we have got various ports under here. We have got an AB mode here on a switch. We've also got 3.5mm auxiliary input. So if you don't want to connect via Bluetooth, you can hardwire something in through the headphone port. Perhaps you've got a smartphone and you want to hardwire it. Slightly better sound through the wired connection than Bluetooth, but they're on par with each other in true sort of listening terms. We've also got here the input for the power supply, and then this is the output. So if you're out and about with this speaker and you find that your smartphone's running out of power, you can use your smartphone's charging cable, and this is a one amp output, so you can actually charge your device. Now, the only negative thing I've got to say about this speaker is this piece of plastic. There's a little indentation here which pushes into the power input, and that's the only thing that really keeps this in place. I would have liked to have seen some extra sort of grippy pieces, maybe to push into the USB port, because it doesn't quite push in how I would like it. I would like this completely flush. I like the material used, but I just wish it would push in a little bit better. It just doesn't quite sit nicely. But that is the only thing, and I'm being very picky here. Other than that, the finish on this device and the build quality and solidity of it is very, very nice indeed. So let's talk about audio quality. That's what's very important. And first of all, I just want to touch on the audio quality when you're using this to take a call. I think it works very well indeed. The actual incoming and outgoing audio quality for phone calls is more than acceptable. So a nice feature and very well implemented. With regards to audio quality, I think you will be very pleasantly surprised. This works extremely well. A nice amount of bass coming from this tiny unit, and the mid-tones and the higher frequencies very, very detailed and well controlled. It's a room-filling device. It will fill a medium to large size room okay. It goes up to a nice large volume. Even at the highest volumes, very minimal distortion. Sometimes with these tiny speakers, when you go up to a high volume, you find that it just distorts so much that it's unusable. Only the tiniest bit of distortion I found here, and that was at the very highest volume. Other than that, it performed very, very well indeed. Now, another nice feature is you can also pair a second one of these. You could have two G2s running, and you could use that for multi-room music. So a nice feature that you can pair a second additional Cambridge Audio G2 into your system. I think it's really nice. It's nice and compact, 189mm, 67mm high, and just 55mm in depth. So nice and compact, makes it easy to take around to various locations as well. Good holiday speaker, or if you're going to a party and you want to take something to really give some decent music and give that party atmosphere, then this is well worth considering. I was really pleased with it, and I think the sort of the bits that stand out for me, apart from the audio quality, is the actual build quality as well. And I really do like the way this top panel's integrated. It's those tiny little attentions to detail that make something stand out from the crowd. This is the Cambridge Audio G2. So thanks very much for watching. Please do hit that like button. Please do subscribe. Check out the links in the video description, and I'll see you all in the next one.